You're listening to the 420 Radio Show on FamousHipHopRadio.com with the Perception Queen and G Money.
I wake up early in the morning and it feels so good. Smoking on some shit that you wish you could. Jealousy, envy, please don't feel bad. This weed is mine, get your own bag. A sack full of OG under lock and key. None for the homies, this is all for me. Got a blunt looking like a Cali palm tree. Police roll by, I got nothing on me. Cause the smoke's already in the air. I'm loped up with two braids in my hair. All star with the khaki suit. I'ma fuck around and take it back to classic Snoop. On the east side, standing on the VIP. Back then, the only red was my EYE. Use a PYT, and you looking so fine. I'm sorry, baby girl, but tonight.
This weed's mine. This weed's mine. You can have it. This weed's mine. This weed's mine. You can have it. This weed's mine.
Back to the episode, sacks full of chronic. Out of this world, could relax on a comic. This is church music, listen to the choir. To burn my kush, you must use fire. D-O-double-G like never heard before. Smoking that bomb like THC4. West Coast worldwide, seashore to seashore. When's the last time you seen a G in a G4? Don't worry, I wait. Time's ticking, I'm tripping, I'm slipping away. Into a zone where these hoes on my dog bone. A dog whistle and they download my ringtone. And she's so hypnotized by this pimp's poem. What I got here is mine, gon' get your own. I put beats to rhymes, get peace of mind. OZs to dimes and this weed is mine.
They rolling up. Smell what I smoke for the back open up. Good chance if you see me there, I'm smoking one. License to get it from the men who grow the shit. Lil nigga blowing weed for eyes old enough. If I'm in the building, it's hard not to notice it. Hit up Willie, said, dog, I got some hoes to fuck. I'ma fall through with an ounce of that potent shit. Don't trip, bitch, we gon' all sip, blow the whole zip. Let you hit mine, plus you supplying your own little bit. My nigga get high and let the hoes twist. Say you don't fuck with joints, look how you rolled it. They ain't smoking like ours. I'm rolling up papers, they be burning for hours. And if it's fire, I'm smoking the whole thing, getting tired.
This weed's mine.
Yeah.
This weed's mine. You can't have it.
That was hard.
This weed's mine. This weed's mine. You can't have it. This weed is mine. I got a bump for you.
Hello, welcome back.
Oh. You're listening to the 420 Radio Show on FamousHipHopRadio.com with the Perception Queen and G Money.
Welcome back to the 420 Famous Hip Hop Radio. We are here today with Teddy from Keeping It Raw.
So we're really excited to have you here, Miss Teddy. Tell us about yourself.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
I'm Miss Teddy. Known as Album of These Very Own Juicy Ladies. And I created a book that has a bunch of recipes in it.
Awesome.
And what motivated you to get started on this?
Because raw cannabis tastes really bad.
And
just do a straight shot. I couldn't get my kids, my husband, anybody to partake in the raw cannabis. So I just started playing around and creating recipes. They would do the raw cannabis.
And so what have you found that raw cannabis actually works for that you take it for?
I take it for chronic pain. I take it to help. help my blood pressure, my blood sugar. I take it to lose weight, and I take it to fight off cancer and a few other.
Awesome. So, in your life, what areas has it helped personally?
It's helped me lose over 150 pounds.
Awesome.
It helps me manage my fibromyalgia.
Awesome.
My blood pressure.
So your pain levels are down when this is happening.
Oh, yeah. My blood sugar. Mm-hmm. I've gotten off of 25 of the 28 pharmaceuticals.
Yes. So are you on any pharmaceuticals right now?
Just three.
Three?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. That's great.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. It is.
So, so what's your passion behind it? What do you see coming out of it? I mean, you did the book and...
My passion is to see everybody incorporating raw cannabis in their life because it is a vegetable. Mm-hmm. If you use it in your raw form, it's no different than kale. Well, it is different than kale and spinach because it has a lot more cannabinoids and everything in it. Right. I would like to see it on the shelf right next to spinach and kale. I want to see kids eating my raw cannabis sushi or drinking one of the smoothies. It fights off the growth of cancer cells. It fights off everyday aches and pains. Mm-hmm. It just makes for a really good diuretic, and it can save lives.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. That's a great response. We really need to know we have passionate people in the industry, you know, especially seeing it as a superfood and seeing it on the shelves. We actually need that vision to support it and hold it with so many people, not just one person. So we thank you for doing that. Also, what events do you have coming up? Tell us a little bit more about that. I'm so excited about your book coming out. It's been a long time coming.
Yes, it has.
Yes.
Almost 3 years in the making. I finally have the book signing and the pickup event coming up this Saturday, March 10th, from 12 to 4 p.m. at the Kerpel headquarters, which is 4010 Central Avenue next to R. Greenleaf.
Awesome.
Yes.
Go
I'm very
pick
excited.
Up some treats, and then you could go right next to Kerpel afterwards and go visit her and get a book signing.
There you go. Yeah.
Right? What's your favorite strain from R. Greenleaf? Do you go there very often?
No, I don't really go there.
Me either.
We're growers. Yeah. So, you know, we have our own particular strains that we like.
Nice. Which ones do you like or grow?
I enjoy Cannatonic.
Cannatonic.
The high
CBD.
High CBD, low THC. Ours tested 16.6 last time. 16 CBD, 6% THC.
Awesome. That's a good ratio.
And then I enjoy Blue Dream and Pineapple Thai.
Yeah, actually Blue Dream and Durban Poison came in like number one and number two in Colorado. Durban Poison came in number one, made $30 million off of the strain alone. $30 million off of one strain.
Durban Poison.
And then Blue Dream came in second.
Blue Dream's wonderful for
Everybody
my anxiety.
Everybody likes Blue Dream.
Yeah.
It's good for PMS. I heard menopause even. It helps with the hot flashes, inflammation. It helps with so many different things. Blue Dreams is really good. Even the terps that I have at the shop have Blue Dream terps, and they have such a full spectrum of terpene profile in there. It's not just one terpene. It's like 1 to 10 terpenes in there.
That's the joy of the book, is you're adding extra terpenes in with your cannabis because you're adding mangoes or oranges or pineapples or grapes because those all have terpenes along
natural
with it.
Raw terpenes.
And I have a list in there of your fruits and vegetables of what they do, like grapes are your brain food, sweet potatoes are anti-inflammatories, dark cherries are anti-inflammatories. I have a list in there of you can mix certain fruits and vegetables with raw cannabis for a hangover, for a cold, for a headache. So I've given you those in the book as well as a bunch of different recipes.
And how much do they run for the book signing? How much will your book be there?
You know, we haven't figured that out. I'm still arguing.
Oh, okay.
it's in the process of learning.
Okay.
And so I'm still trying to figure out how much I need to charge to pay for taxes and shipping and printing
everything.
It's the very first time we've done this, Anthony, as well as myself. He's used to doing magazines.
Yeah.
So this is the first time we've gotten together and done a book. It turned out to be a quite a headache, but we got it done. So now it's just a matter of getting the website up, getting it out.
The hard part's out of the way.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Look at how far you came. The hard part is out of the way. Rest, girl, right now.
It's already on
because
press.
Because it's going to take a hold once it gets out of there.
All we have to do is call and say, hey, we need 100 more copies, and it's done. We don't have to send it to them, get it approved, get anything done. But awesome. We're still working on all of that.
Okay. And also, you have your clothing line. So, I mean, you're wearing your clothes now, and it looks amazing. So, tell us a little bit about your clothing line. Where can we get that? Where can we see you at next? Do you have any events planned that you're going to be venting at?
I have one coming up at 7 Clover.
Okay.
The St. Patty's Day.
Okay. So, and March 17th at 7 Clover.
We are focusing more on the book.
Mm-hmm.
So, we will have some of the clothes in the back to catch the people's attention. But, we're focusing more now on the knowledge.
That's good.
And in the book of the raw cannabis as it is and can save lives.
Okay.
And it can help with weight loss. I've got another book in the works that is weight loss with cannabis. And then the third book is our infusion confusion, which will incorporate some of our infused recipes with the raw recipes, like our infused quiche with our raw cannabis bagel with the raw cannabis cheese spread.
Yum.
So we've got two more books in the works.
Awesome. How exciting. Yes.
So we'll be focusing a lot on the books, and then we'll just have the clothing line, like I said, because people like to be drawn in with
stuff, and you have some good deals too. Skirts and dresses, and I'm like, oh, let me have them all.
They're fun. They catch the eye. It gets the conversation going.
Oh, for sure. And especially in the business that we're in, we need to be talking to a lot of people. So,
Most definitely.
Well, what's your favorite strand? Did you say Canatonic is going to be your favorite out of all? Or what's your absolute favorite strand?
Yeah, we were talking. I like Williams Wonder.
I've never heard of that. Williams Wonder. Okay, well, we'll have to try it.
It would be more of a female strain.
Okay. Like
aphrodisiac,
Jilly,
well.
Like Jilly Bean's a female strain as well. It helps with a lot of PMS, different things, mood swings. It helps with so many
things.
This one
is more depression.
Oh, okay. I didn't think of that, but cool.
Yeah, this one is
Williams
is
Wonder.
Mm-hmm.
It would be called a guy's name. I'm like, what?
I think C.G. Corrigan's carries it.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah, and we found a seed.
Thank you. Good to know. Yes, well, I know you're in the kitchen making some good products all the time, so I know you have, like, the best of the best, so thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Thank
Do you have anything else you want to share before we go to a commercial or anything?
The books we will have out, CBD Boutique, Gina.
Okay.
Has pre-ordered 25 of them, so she'll have those out. Natural RX, we'll have the books out.
Yes.
We'll have a link up with Anthony from Purple Magazine.
Yes.
And you can contact me on my Facebook page, at Learn From Teddy.
Okay.
And I'm on Twitter, Miss Teddy. I'm on Instagram, Miss Teddy's Juicing. So you can catch me there. I'm on LinkedIn, also, Miss Teddy. Okay.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, guys, for listening in. Just so you guys know, she will be this Saturday again at Kirpal doing her book signing and release party as well. The address, Miss Teddy, to that once again?
4010 Central.
Okay. And that's in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And we're going to go ahead and get back to the music. And also want to go ahead and let you guys know you can listen to us also by requesting Alexa on Amazon to play Famous Hip Hop Radio live. So that's a new feature that we have here. Please utilize that and catch us on Amazon Alexa as well. Thank you so much, and we'll be back with you in a second.
Thank you.
Well, that sounds great.
Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice, 'cause I speak of the pompousness of love. People talk about me, baby, say I'm doing you wrong, doing you wrong. Well, don't you worry, baby, don't worry, 'cause I'm right here, right here.
grinner. I'm a lover and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. I sure don't want to hurt no one. I'm a picker, I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. Give my love and all.
To the 420 radio show on FamousHipHopRadio.com with the Perception Queen and G Money.
Yo, what's up? This is Tajay of the Mighty Souls of Mischief Crew. I'm chilling with my man Festo, my man A Plus, and my man Oak. You know, he's dope. Yeah. And right now, you know, we're just maxing in the studio. We're hailing from East Oakland, California, and sometimes it gets a little hectic out there. But right now, you know, we're going to up you on how we just chill.
Down for 7 digits, call up Bridget, her man's a midget. Yo, I can dig it. Here's a 40 swigging. You know it's frigid. I got him chilling in the cooler. Break out the ruler. Damn, that's the fattest dog I ever seen. The weather's heating, Cali getting weeded. Makes it feel like Maui. Now we feel the good vibrations. So many females, so much inspiration.
I get inspired by the blunts too. I'll front you, you. If you hang with the bunk crew, I roam the strip for bones to pick. When I find one, I'm gonna take her home and quickly do this. Yeah. I need not explain this.
420 Radio Show on FamousHipHopRadio.com with the Perception Queen and G Money.
The remix.
We creeping in too, baby.
We got five on everything, man.
We got Drew Down. We got the Looney.
Shot G.
No, we got the Yuck Man.
Yeah, Richie Rich. Eat Foden.
Spice Hurricane.
You say you got five on my tender, you can bend her over the table, but be sure that you bring my stallion back to my stable. Say, bruh, no elementary school ground playing, not a $5 bill, but 500 on the real field. I'm on the level, stay mellow, no criticism from the fellows. Hello, being key during the high speed, but still don't tap the BB. I'm DD, Drew Down, baby.
Like NyQuil, I drop fever. So either put your five up, or you got to leave it like Diva. Cause see ya, Niggy burping, broke a smoke, you slip all day. Go home and buy Big Tricky with his pretty, then parlay. I got five on the Hennessy, Seagrams or Gordons. Cause this is how we do it like Montel Jordan. I'm from the Oakland City, Frank Nitti is a donut. Now I'm blowing it up like Oklahoma.
Put your feet with my fin, best believe we'll bend. More corners than you thought, to something right is bought. Most C-Zacks believe that. Token, where you from? Oakland, smoking in attempts to crack the chest plate. The zips be so fluffy, the whole town love me. At every event, I'm sacked up, so if you need me, scream double R when you see me.
So bad. 40 makes it happen. Fives get slacking, revenue gross, and just a little bit of lightweight. Flambeaux and potent fumes linger. Mighty clouds of northern lights. Respect to Victor Baron, and you'll be violating my civil rights. I'm starting to feel my skrilla, but perhaps today my skrill ain't feeling me. For the simple fact that I'm off to the track with hella fools be. Pockets empty, pitching five, man, I'm thirsty. Took off my hat, passed it around.
Me and these 40 to the head, coming fit plus. Yuck, let the lead bust. Ready to do a murder, man. Purge off the hurricane, learn the game. Witness what being off 2/5 equal. Me killing people like Jason, facing death every sequel.
Insane in the membrane.
Bring the pain like method, neglected. Smoking kryptonite to the brain for breakfast. Guzzle the Hindu, fence to do the evil that men do. Give me feed, I shall proceed and continue.
Around and hurry up, get numb. Said I gotta be down, cause new styles is going down. Look around you, tunes from the loon spreading round and round you. Back to get my O on, they let me flow on. The 35 on it, yeah, I'm on it. Still bringing satin for them draws. Velvet for the mic and got a pound for the cause. Rolling
up cannabis sativa, hitting a Mary Jane. Smoking a 5 before it's 12 o'clock, sipping on hurricane. Better to smoke on the endo, rolling up my window. Finna go to the land, with a handful of broccoli. When it comes to the sticky, I'm the man. Crunch nasty, I be hitting the J so hard I Earl. Falling on the floor, finna have a stroke. THC ain't no joke. I got 5 on everything, let's be loaded and smoke. SPICE about to hit it and crow.
What's up, baby? It's me, your boy with the cape that's always tight. You're a little short on some ends.
You're listening to the 420 Radio Show on FamousHipHopRadio.com.
Welcome back
Three, two, one.
Welcome back to Famous Hip Hop Radio. We're here with
G Money,
and he does have a guest with him as well. What's your guest name today, G-Money?
It's KV, UG Enterprises.
Awesome.
Game News from Portland, Oregon.
Awesome. So introduce him a little bit. Tell us a little bit about him before you get him on the line.
He's already on the line.
Oh, okay.
I'm just trying to, hey, you guys got to bear with me because I just got this phone today. And I'm really trying to, you there, fam?
Learning curve.
Uh-oh. Hello?
Someone put money on blast.
Hey.
In the background.
Wait a minute. Hello? Okay, yeah. See, for some reason, I don't even know how to put this dang speaker on speakerphone. I hit speaker and it didn't go on it. Watch. Okay. Man, I know, man.
Don't worry, hey, I got you.
You know, I'm more of a personal person anyway. You know, this is all new anyway. You know what I mean? But yeah, but I introduced you already, fam. You go ahead and let everybody know who you is.
Man, my name is KG. I'm from Portland, Oregon, the city of Rose, where everything is green, the color money, man. I represent Unlimited Game Enterprises. Gang News is the brand. You can go ahead and slap that at any hashtag that in, man, and find me anywhere. Shout out to, Go There Magazine, man, C Money and the whole staff, man, for having me on, man, and, having me on to speak, man, and I just really appreciate that.
Hey, we appreciate you, too, because, what we're trying to do is reach out to people everywhere, you know what I mean, and find out what's really going on with the movement because, it's different in a lot of places because, people, they have their own agendas and it's so hard for them to come together, you know what I mean, because they'd be so worried about their agenda and it should be bigger than them, you know what I mean?
Giving us this particular platform. The reason why I say us is because it is about us. Famous hip hop, West Coast Hip Hop Awards, Wellness Seminar, Go There, the whole shebang. And I'm just glad to be able to come on, man, and explain this.
Yes, sir.
For cheap money, man. And I just want to just say thank you, man, for the whole platform.
It's good, fam. It's good. And we all, I'm quite sure, we all say you welcome.
You're welcome.
You know what I mean? Yeah, because we all here. You know what I mean? This is live. You know what I mean? It ain't just me talking to him. Anybody can talk to him. You know what I mean? But anyway, just so you guys do know, KV, he's the one who's putting on the wellness event that he merged with the West Coast Hip Hop Awards.
Excellent. Then I'll be able to meet him.
Yes.
Thank you. I'll be there.
Talk about it. Yeah. Okay, so go ahead and let us know, fam.
Well, as my bro, Octavius Miller, next for the promotions. It's been doing the West Coast Hip Hop Awards, it's our 11th year. It's been going on actually probably about maybe 13. And they're kind of like in the background a lot,
mm-hmm.
With that. Last couple of years, I was just like, KV, man, how can we incorporate, the wellness and the medical marijuana, because I'm, advocate and kind of deep here in Portland, Oregon. In that field, as well as, entertainment and, music and all of that. So I got to brainstorm it here and I got to brainstorm it. I said, man, let's just do a wellness seminar, man, and educate, our people within the hip hop industry, on what's going on in the industry, if they know, if they may not know, and then explain to them what the difference is in having a medical card and not having a medical card. Explain the differences between medical and recreational, and that's where it started from, right then and there.
Yeah.
It's just educating just the main individual, I'm pretty sure you understand, G Money.
Oh, yes,
sir. In a lot of states, a lot of people, a lot of us are saying, well, I don't need my medical card or my rec card. I can just go in and, I can just go into a dispensary now and just go buy anything. Well, yeah, that's true. Okay. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yep.
That's true, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Okay. Now, what we did last year in Oakland is I just explained the differences, okay, of having a medical card versus not having a medical card. Okay? And I explain those differences, compared and contrast, and just basically came up with the analogy of similar to having a driver's license, trying to work at UPS or FedEx.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have a driver's license at UPS or FedEx, you're just going to be a dock worker, and you're probably going to make no more than $13, $14, $15 an hour. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay? If you have a driver's license, okay, where does that put you?
That puts you in a better position.
Hey, G-Money, man, look here. What did you just say?
Put you in
a better position.
Yes, sir.
Dig what I'm talking about?
Yes, I could dig it. I totally could dig it. Because position is everything.
Put a 10-foot shovel, man. So
yeah.
We show reality.
We
break things down. We break factual scenarios down into reality. Okay? And it took off from there. Not only with just, you know, that aspect of, you know, having a wreck and not having a wreck and the advantages and the disadvantages of them, but it broke off into getting into the industry. What I mean by that is trying to set up your own grow operation legally, get into the business of getting a dispensary legally, branding and marketing a strain legally. You know, there are a lot of different opportunities.
Avenues.
That come along with having a medical and or a red card, depending on what your state regulated laws are.
Yeah.
You understand what I mean?
Yes,
that
sir.
That makes sense.
That makes too much sense.
So,
I'm with
that's
you.
That's pretty much where we're at with that, where I went with that. And as I got to doing a lot more interacting and engaging with the people in the industry, outside of my state, okay, I started realizing, and don't laugh, man, but this is the truth, that there are a lot of women winning in this industry, man.
That's right. That's right. You guys
That's
don't even
truth.
Know we're taking over.
You know what I'm saying, man? Really?
It's a girl plant. It's a girl female spirit, so.
You know what I'm saying, man? So, because, in Oregon, my grower, okay, one of the best, if not the best, farms, I believe, here in Oregon. Shout out to Righteous Fire and Fire Gardens here in Oregon, man. I'm trying to get Stephanie and my husband, Chris Malott, to come up to Oregon and put on a seminar. Shout out to them, man. She really actually put me in the game.
Yeah.
That's right.
Just say a woman put me in the game, man.
I'm not going to be the
first one to tell you that, man. Seriously, I don't have a problem saying that, man.
Okay. Yeah, I can dig it.
Credit is due.
A lot of men can't admit to that, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You dig?
You know I can dig it.
Man, I don't know if it's an ego thing.
No.
Some machoism. I don't know what ism it is.
It's because
it's the right,
there's
you know,
been so much male energy ruling the planet for so long that it's time for a shift in energy to happen for the world to be balanced, and people are finally waking up to that. And it takes men like you to really say it and put it out there, and for other men to be very comfortable with it, because it's a whole different virtue, you know, when women come in a business. And for women to be running 75% of these cannabis businesses and entrepreneurship in the cannabis industry really says something. And when somebody actually notices it from the other side, it becomes an inclusion, and it becomes everything that this plant is trying to do, is wake people up on both sides, not just on a male aspect, because we have masculine and feminine energy in all of us. And it's really about recognizing it and holding on to both powers. We don't want to override the male. We want to be one with it, so that way our energies can coincide and we really make something
something of this world that we really haven't seen before. So thank you so much for sharing that aspect of that.
Well, I'm humbly thank you for
You're welcome. I can't hold it back. That's passion.
Yeah.
I mean, like, really, man. I'm like, ooh, okay.
This is the 420 show, man.
Not trying to change the game. We're just trying to educate it.
Yeah.
Cookies and cream.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Put the world on blast.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean, man? So,
Thank you.
I just wanted to, but this year, since I noticed that, and then, ironically, at the seminar in the West Coast Hip Hop Awards in Oakland this last August and 17th, you know, we were fortunate enough, you know, shout out to Cannabis Talk Radio, Rudy Nacredi, Union the Dank, Hip Hop Weekly, you know, and Moon Rocks with Gail Gotti and Corrupt. We were able to have Gail. I'm serious. We were able to have Gail on the seminar, okay, and speak about how she and Moon Rocks are moving, you know, and her packaging and things of that nature and the things that she's doing with her brand as far as combating, you know, some of the medical issues that this particular plant can, you know, help, you know, such as cancer, you know.
When she came up there
and was speaking on the panel, you know, and then with the West Coast Hip Hop Awards, and then we had Sugar T do her women's empowerment. Okay. You had to be there because it ended up being a woman's affair. And, you know, me and I was talking about that. It was really beautiful to see Sugar T put on her women's empowerment and had Gail Gotti come up and speak about her Moon Rocks. And that right there, it dawned on me.
Powerful.
Yeah.
Explosive.
Yeah. Yeah.
You I can know, just imagine. I can't wait.
I just wanted to something to say, KV, man. So that was in August, right? Well,
yes, sir.
The show don't stop, okay? It was successful. The show don't stop. So we ended up, through those networking contacts, okay, building up all of those networking contacts and strengthening their relationships. Okay.
Yeah.
So what I found out is it's a whole lot more women around here. It's the industry. Like, really, like, understand me.
Yeah.
Going to the bank with this shit, man, right? So,
yeah.
So, the more research and the more contacts that I'm making, you know, everywhere, it seemed like everywhere I went, man, I was dealing with a professional woman. So, what I decided to do was say, you know what, man? So, well, I'm a rewind, a lose to this, okay? So I started doing more research, okay?
That's right.
Women in weed and women in the cannabis. Do you know that at least 45%, and it's growing, okay, 45% of the medical, of the cannabis industry is run by women.
Yeah,
that's a fact. You can Google it. Somebody can pull out their device right now and Google it. Okay.
Yeah.
Not only that, in Oregon, okay, in Oregon and Washington. Now remember, man, I live in the Pacific Northwest, okay?
Yeah.
In Portland, Oregon, which is right up underneath the state of Washington, Seattle, which is right up on top of California. Okay?
Yeah.
So we're right in the middle. Get it? Man, you go and go to a lot of these, what they call them, vendor conventions. And you do a lot of these conventions. You're going to a lot of these growers, and you know, you go out to the actual site, and you know, you're looking around, and there's women out there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The dispensary.
There's women growing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So. Mm-hmm. I got to. The deeper I got, the more successful women I started finding out everywhere. Okay, so I said, you know what, man, this is just great. So let me salute the women of the industry.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
In Seattle. No, in Seattle. Seriously, man. This is number two for me. This is number 11 with the whole West Coast Hip Hop Awards. I'm a part of the West Coast Hip Hop Awards, but this is a branch off. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Of the awards, which is the wellness seminar, you know, and I just said, fuck it, Katie, just go ahead since you know about this shit, just handle it. And I'm handling it, okay?
Right.
But I'm telling you guys right now, what we're finding out, okay, is this women in here. So what I decided to do, man, is salute the women of the industry and invite the minorities and the women of the industry that want to be a part of it to come up if they want, you know, to the booth, in the booth with their products, this, that, and the other, and be on the panel and speak about their experiences and let them converse and speak. Not only that, if you're from out of state, you're also going to be pioneering a new demographic market, which is the Pacific Northwest, which is the most untapped business market in the United States.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
If people don't know that, okay.
Yeah, I didn't know
I'm
that.
I'm going to give you an example. I'm just going to give you an example. Three of the most successful brands, okay, are stationed right here in Portland and Seattle. But I'm going to tell you who they are. One of them is Nike. Phil Knight is from Portland, Oregon. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Branched out Nike in Beaverton. Okay.
Yeah.
Hi. Headquarters. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is Paul Allen. Okay. Paul Allen owns the Blazers and Seattle Seahawks. Okay.
Uh-huh.
His partner, Paul Allen, is old boy over there at Apple and Microsoft. What's his name?
You talk about Gates?
Bill Gates.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear what I just said?
Yes, sir. I just heard what you just said. Man,
I heard what Manny said.
Yeah, you are speaking Yiddish right now.
He is. I'm listening. Usually, I'm the only one speaking Yiddish.
Yeah.
When somebody comes up speaking it, I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And.
I understand
exactly where you're going with this. Because you know what? Because, you know, like the conversation we was having earlier today, you know, like. As far as the whole dispensaries and stuff, I'm quite sure it's the same way everywhere, because as far as if you don't have no money, it's hard for a minority to even get into the business.
And that right there is another topic of discussion.
Yeah.
Okay? That's why we're choosing women. Okay?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Do you understand what I'm saying? The magnitude of what I'm saying?
Yes, I totally understand.
What was we just talking about earlier today, G-Money? Who spends the most money?
Women.
Who buys the most stuff?
Women. Because they need all kind of stuff. Men only need like deodorant, toothpaste, lotion
shampoo.
If they lucky.
You know that works for shampoo, conditioner, and like shave stuff. So they need like three things.
I'm just stating true facts.
Yes, sir.
These are true facts.
Yeah, they are.
If you're an R&B promoter,
this is right.
If you're an R&B promoter,
that's right.
G-Money, you know the game.
Yes.
Who are you trying to get? And
people,
who are you,
listen up. This is a smart man that we have.
Wait a minute, I couldn't hear you, fam.
If you're an R&B promoter,
yeah.
Okay. If R&B, who are you promoting to?
Oh, you're promoting the older generation.
Yeah,
women.
But what sex?
Oh, women.
Yeah, R&B.
Exactly. Check out. They gonna come and see.
It's a no-brainer.
112. They gonna come and see Elder Barge. They're gonna come and see Tony, man. They're gonna pay that dollar, man. And guess what? The guy is gonna pay it too.
He's gonna and he's coming
twice.
He's coming with drink money.
He's gonna pay it twice. Yeah, he's gonna pay it twice. He might pay it three times.
Yeah.
Or four. Depending on her. You know what I'm saying? So I just said that to say this, man.
Real spill.
This is a tribute and a seminar recognizing the minorities and women in the cannabis industry, man.
That's big. That's big.
And I don't think, and it's coming from our hip-hop culture, okay?
Yeah.
And honestly, I don't think no one else is ever is doing this.
No.
No, this no, is
ain't
big.
Nobody else
this
doing
is huge.
It. Ain't nobody else doing
not
it.
Not on a seminar level,
and
not
I'm
at all.
I'm an innovative-minded difference maker, man. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I really am. I'm an innovative-minded difference maker. Outside of everything else, the music you might hear, outside of everything else, man, you're dealing somebody. You're going to be dealing with a business-minded individual.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, spiritually,
and
you're waking people up.
I'm saluting the women in the weed cannabis industry at the Emerald City Wellness Seminar, August 4th in Seattle with the West Coast Hip Hop Awards.
That's right.
Because,
you know, I'll definitely be in attendance.
We got some 420 models coming down out of the Seattle area. An extract company ran by women. Working on it's still in its infant stages because we got like what 4 or 5 months out, and
yeah.
I'm just getting a lot of things and a lot of responses that I have to respond back to.
Yeah.
And it's I'm telling you, man, I believe this is going to be really nice. This is going to be big, man. This is going to be big.
It sounds like it. It really sounds like it.
And I just want to say shout out to everybody that helped me on last year, number one. Not only that, the women that helped me last year were number one. If it wasn't for, you know, Gail Gotti's testimonial, man, with Cannabis Talk and Blue and, you know, Mark Wasserman, the Pop Brothers and Rudy and my guy Smirkman, man, you know, and, you know, my dude John Lee out of Encino, California, he'll be up, too. They're coming up, too. And this is beautiful, man. I just got blessed by a woman in the game, man. And, you know, we're going to try to give her a lovely shout-out, man. Just say thank you, not only to her, but all the other women that, you know, I want to come down and be a part. So this time I'm going to really film this joint. I got a film crew, so I'm going to bring my own personal film crew up, man. We're just going to go to work, man.
Okay. And like, let's just say somebody's listening and they want to be a part of it. How do they get a hold of you?
Well, my email address for the awards, if you want to get any information about vendor booths and, you know, the state laws, regulating and things of that nature to the wellness seminar, you can email me at aplayerspoints@outlook.com. Okay? And then from there, I can shoot you over all of the vendor contracts and information. And there are actual speaker, if you want to be a panel member speaker, there are discounts that are applied, okay, depending on where you want to put your booth at. We got a really nice spot in downtown Seattle, the Washington Hall. If you've never been to Seattle, it's going to be a beautiful thing. Seattle's very pretty.
Yes, it is. Space Needle.
That's why, you know, seafood, if you're a seafood connoisseur,
I know I am. I'm a pescatarian, so I'll be eating that.
Because you know, right now, we have a basically a room full of women that's in, actually
that's
in,
right
that's in the industry.
G-Money's that, surrounded that by
I'm,
women.
I'm surrounded by them.
He has no choice. He ain't going nowhere.
And they all know they stuff, fam. I mean, they all know they stuff. You know, I mean, I've been blessed just to just be around. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I've been a recluse, kind of. You know what I mean? And, you know, they say that's not healthy. You know, but you know, I'm still working on my PTSD.
He needs to find a strain that works for him.
Yeah, yeah. Man,
we need to do some strain hunting, man, for you, G Money.
Hey,
we
you know,
got you. We need to do that for you.
I don't even smoke enough, though.
We need to figure out what it is. Because I know smoking takes mine away, so we need to figure out the right
measurements
for you.
I need a different alternative because I'm not. I've never really been a pot smoker.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. So it's like. It's like out of my element.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I like to be functional.
Yeah.
You know? Oh. Keep it.
That would kill him, y'all.
We got Miss Teddy's.
Keeping it raw, y'all. Keeping it raw.
Yeah. Keeping it raw. Yes. Yeah, I need the book.
You need the raw cannabis without the psychoactive effects, Money. That's what it is.
Yeah, it is.
Marijuana, you're engaging in, okay?
Yeah.
You know, me, I'm a kush connoisseur. I can't sit down. I mean, I'm a hyper type of dude anyway.
I got a sports background.
I went to college playing ball and things of that nature. So I can't, you know, I have to be doing something.
Yeah, me too.
Now, in order for me to sit my ass down and take shit, ride and be like on cruise control, man, I gotta have like some OG 18, OG Kush, cookies and cream, Star.
GDP is a good
one. What is that? Starfire OG,
something ridiculous.
Something to where, you know, it calms you down. You know what I'm saying?
Mm hmm. Well, you know what? I can honestly say it is something that I did smoke that one of our family members had, the Duke of Herb, the same one who did the First Lady's Kush Strand. He has some cherry phantom cookies. Oh. Now, that right there, I was cool.
You need more of that. Let's get you more of that money.
You know what I mean? I mean, I was cool. Because, you know, I've
never heard of that.
He's got some stuff a lot of people ain't never heard of.
Mm-hmm. Same guy with the bear trap, y'all.
That's what I would love to actually one day do.
Uh-huh.
One day with the seminar.
Yeah.
That's what I would love to do one time, one year with the seminar. I'm going to do it this year.
Mm-hmm.
But we can only, because of regulations.
Uh-huh.
Okay, laws, state by state, you know, someone from California can't just take their weed over the border no more.
No.
It's really, seriously, you can, okay, fuck it, you can, take the risk.
Yeah, as long as you ain't really got no weight, you might be all right. You know what I mean? As long as it's like a little, you know, as long as a little bit.
Card.
Yeah. But
on you.
Just these laws, and every time I talk to, you know, guys that I'm affiliated with that are in the industry,
uh-huh,
as lawyers,
mm-hmm,
and things of that nature, and activists, and, you know, bill pushers, ballot pushers,
yeah,
you know, things of that nature, these are the things that they speak to me about. You know, every day, almost every other week within the cannabis legislation, there's something brand new. There's mm-hmm. something brand new. And one piece of the puzzle affects another piece of the puzzle. Just ask those ladies right there, other witches that are in the industry. Mm-hmm. They'll tell you they probably got a whole bunch of stuff that they got to re-look at and figure out, God damn, man, how is this going to fit? God damn, why did they do this? Oh, shit. Yeah. Like Prop 215.
We're in the middle of a session right now.
I mean, it's a lot of shit. Like right now, man, in Washington, they have an issue with home grow. In California, they having issues with recertification. Okay, they shutting mamas and pops get, you know, shots down because California, you know, for a long time, they had a black market. Anybody can open a damn weed business.
Oh, yeah, out there.
But when the government found out, hey, man, everybody ain't paying us.
Oh, where's my money?
Yeah.
And they said, oh, holy shit, we're one of the biggest states in the whole 50. We got to do something about this. So this is what happened. Somebody got on the telephone with a motherfucker here in Oregon and Washington, California. How are you guys regulating this shit? This is how we're doing it. So they came back after they got all the information and restructured California.
Mm-hmm.
That's why about a month and a half ago, even right now, they busting motherfuckers. Some motherfuckers is, you know, having to go into redoing the paperwork and all that type of shit, man. I'm telling you, but something is real. This is what's really going on right now.
Yeah.
Ask one of them ladies. Ask a few of them ladies. Am I right?
You're right. 100% right. These are factual news events.
Yep. You got some nines. You got four nines.
Oh, I got four nines?
Yep.
Really?
Yeah, you got four nines, huh?
That's what happened.
That's exactly what happened.
That's what happened. And check this out.
They just started regulating for pesticides, too, so in your area. So
this is the cool thing about it, man. Okay? Every part of California is being delegated differently.
Because they're different councils.
Yep, that's true.
They're different
It's being delegated and regulated differently. Ain't that about it, Pierce? Excuse my language, but
that's how all the laws are.
Well, here in Southern California, we're going to take you. You're going to be abiding by this part of the law. If you're in Middle California,
right,
you're going to abide by this part
That's how regular laws are.
Yeah, they're looking motherfuckers upside the head right now, man.
$300 to get your car.
Yeah.
Plain and simple. Doesn't matter who you are, what you do. It's $300.
Wow. Arizona, it's $300 to get a card out there.
How much in California?
It's only like $50 to $100.
It's not that
California,
expensive in Cali.
It's not. Even at the events, you get them like $40.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah. And has anybody here ever been to Amsterdam?
Not yet. I plan on going there, but not yet.
No, Amsterdam. Amsterdam is a college.
Yeah, it's the
Amsterdam,
college.
The college in Oakland, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, man, check G-Money.
Yes, sir.
Amsterdam was in Oakland at the wellness seminar with us.
Oh, awesome. I bet, because, you know, they are good supporters.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're good supporters.
It's about education.
Yeah.
That's what he's about, so.
Yeah, man. And what you guys are talking about in the background, these are some of the issues that are going to be talked about and spoken about, these topics, at the wellness seminar. What law? That's why I'm trying to get a representative from almost every legal state. You understand what I'm saying? So we can sit down and compare and contrast these notes. Well, how is the federal government treating you in Michigan? And then my partner from Michigan get up and talk. And then, you know, somebody from Seattle is talking. What is this going on? And then I got somebody from Oregon talking about, okay, well, this is what's going on here. And then I got somebody from Northern California, somebody from Middle California, somebody from Southern California.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to be contacting you. I'll be your representative for New Mexico because I'm in the middle of New Mexico Impact. We do a lot of lobbying. We do a lot of the law change. Well, we want to change a lot of the laws. So we're in there learning. We're in there with the lobbyists. We're in there with city councils. We're in there with senators just talking and making sure we're getting the laws changed here as we needed to do safety applications for kids and stuff like that too. So that way they could take their medicine with them to school. So it's something that we're actively working on all the time. So I definitely want to be there. So if we could do something like that, you could look up New Mexico Impact and kind of see what we're about. And I would love to like be there and be a representative for New Mexico. That would be huge. And Miss Teddy said that she might want to go too. So maybe we will have two people from New Mexico there, but I'm definitely going to get in contact with you. I really appreciate everything that you're doing in the industry right now. It's huge.
Oh, thank you. Thank
of course.
Thank you. Not a problem. I mean, you know, that's what this wellness seminar is about. It's about educating, teaching, uplifting, you know, and we're doing it within our hip-hop culture.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We're doing it within our hip hop culture. I'm trying to get as many lobbyists and, you know, lawyers involved as we most possibly can, so we actually know who's on our team as far as this community is concerned, mm-hmm. that we actually have. You know, and to say that, I say that to say this. What I truly believe, okay, I truly believe, man, that there's one law, okay, there's one law right now that is enabling the cannabis industry to help out the community, okay? Did you know that dispensary owner companies, cannabis industry company owners cannot donate money to charities?
I didn't know that.
Who all knows that?
I didn't know that.
Okay, everybody in the room except me.
And me.
Okay, it's two.
Yeah, it's half of the room. It was a 50% for sure.
Big game.
I knew.
Big game, G Money.
Yeah.
I know you can't, like, donate money for medicine, but I didn't know for that.
Okay, hypothetically speaking, okay?
I bet it's world, like the same thing.
Let's just say, yeah, because they say it's money laundering.
Oh,
it's money laundering, huh?
They consider it money laundering.
What?
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Look here, man. Big gang. I coach youth football. I got a 501c3 nonprofit organization.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? We go out. One of my things after this type of seminar and things of this nature, that's why I'm trying to put all this together before spring football pops up. Okay?
Yeah.
I got a bunch of third through eighth graders that I really take care of. I've been doing this for 15, 16 years. I got kids in college. I got kids in the NFL. I got kids in the NBA. Okay?
Yeah.
It's real shit. Okay? Be good. 2 years ago, I'm out trying to raise funds with, you know, for my youth program. Okay? We got a sponsorship letter. That sponsorship letter has, you know, three levels of sponsorships, okay, with our TIN number, which is your tax ID number for 501c3 organization.
Mm-hmm.
Organization, okay? So I can go out to AT&T. I can go to, you know, a lot of these major corporations, they have a budget of the year for such charity.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay? Okay? Now, my job is to go out and pinpoint those guys, okay, so we can get as much donated stuff as we most possibly can, because at the end of the year, it's a tax write-off for a business.
That's
okay?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
For a business, right?
They yes, do that sir. All the time.
Did you know can a business cannot do that?
What?
Can a business, yeah, if you're in the can of business, you cannot donate any funds to any charitable organization.
But can they donate to you? Can other people donate to you?
Money laundering. That is something, hopefully in the future, with this wellness seminar, and us trying to, and we're trying to connect
state to
state. I
wonder if only in his state.
So we want to put on
I want it, it's here too?
It's everywhere.
Yeah, it's because it's federal then. That's
yeah.
Why.
Yeah.
We want that on the ballot. Because yeah. Gay, hypothetically speaking, let's just say.
So the state is illegal too. So we.
Let's just say such and such strain. Okay. Such and such strain company, CBD company, decides they want to give $5,000 to the Boys and Girls Club in their city as a tax writer, as a donation from such and such CBD company, right?
Yeah.
To the Boys and Girls Club or Salvation Army.
Well, now that I think
or
about
the Girl Scouts. They can't do it.
You could loophole it. You could actually make the money yourself,
I'm
and
so
then you could
glad
donate
you said that
personally.
Word.
I'm like, I try to go above and beyond. I'm so sorry. We still got to make this shit work. And a way to still do it,
see,
it is
see,
taking your
you
own personal money and
yeah.
actually don't
in?
Donating it that
sure,
way instead.
Yeah.
Write it off on your taxes. Who cares?
Right.
Green money. What was we talking about earlier today? before the show. Loophole language.
Loophole language. Loophole. And that's it. Yeah.
I couldn't help it. I couldn't help it.
And we were just talking about that today, the loophole language, and that a lot of people need to understand that, because a lot of people don't understand it.
Yep.
You know, they don't understand.
That's where we're floating right now.
Who was that young lady that said
it's Perception Queen?
That's the Perception Queen.
See?
Yeah.
That's why we salute the women of the industry, man.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So they can come and share this information.
That's
okay?
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
These are the things and the topics that are going to be talked about, okay, that are going to be on this panel. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're going to take these people to school. They want to sit down, okay? It's not going to be listening to rap music and all the rap stars is walking around and popping it and, you know, everybody getting high. That's what they think. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But I'm here right now. Say this on your radio station.
Huge.
No, that's not what it's about. Okay, trust me. That's not what
listen
it's
up,
about.
Y'all. Listen up. This is real game right here.
A whole bunch of hip hop potheads walking around popping collars and smoking weed and no.